Sue Moroney.
Speaker, and I think that last contribution on this bill goes to show that the National Party has no idea what meal breaks and rest periods are all about. Because not once in that member's contribution, nor virtually at all in the minister's contribution, did they address the question of health and safety in the workplace. Because that is exactly what meal breaks and rest periods are all about. It's not about people having this right to somehow spend some time chatting with their workmates. It's actually about all the research and evidence that exists not only in New Zealand but internationally that tells us that when workers are fatigued, when they haven't had the opportunity to rehydrate, when they haven't had the opportunity to eat, that is when things go wrong at work. And Mr Speaker, when I talk about things going wrong at work, I'm not just talking about a widget not being produced properly. I'm not talking about perhaps the shareholders not getting their maximum profit out of the workplace that they might have wanted to have got on that day. I'm talking about people losing their lives, Mr Speaker. And that's the seriousness of the sort of bill that we are addressing here this evening. And what the National Party is doing is they say that they are introducing flexibility. They're actually giving a recipe for disaster into these workplaces. Because, Mr Speaker, the Minister spoke about giving the flexibility so that workers could decide to have their break at the end of the shift. Well, let's think about that from a health and safety perspective. If someone's working in an environment where they've worked for 8 hours before they get to have a break because the wonderful flexibility that this bill affords, that they've used that to not have a break for 8 hours, and on hour 7.5, they make the big fatal mistake that either ends their life or that of a co-worker, then is the minister going to stand up and take responsibility for that because she's allowed that flexibility into that workplace? Because that's exactly what the National Party are proposing here. They are proposing to introduce into a workplace where they know the power relationship is uneven. This idea that workers and their employer will sit down together and just mutually agree that workers aren't going to have their break until the end of the shift is a complete nonsense, and they know it. The employer will be making these decisions. That's what this bill is all about. It's all about giving carte blanche to the employer to decide what is in their best interest in terms of productivity. Never mind the health and safety of the workforce. Never mind about what workers actually want to do. But let's just give that right over to the employer to decide how they're going to do it. Well, that has had some really disastrous results in the past, which is why Labor brought a bill before this House and successfully put it through the Parliament. And yes, I am proud of that, Mr Bennett. And as a member who's actually got some legislation through this House, then, you know, I know that if Mr Bennett ever achieves that, he might also understand how important it is that when you've actually gone through that process, that you don't get a government come along afterwards who never warned anyone they were going to do it, comes along and tampers with that and actually takes the impact of it away. Because when I came into Parliament, one of the things that I did want to do was ensure that we had better work-life balance for people not within this precinct, Mr Speaker. I'm sure you understand that, but better work-life balance for all New Zealanders. And that's why this bill was so important, because what it actually did was it ensured that workers did have the right to take breaks at work. And listening to the National Party debating this issue, one would think, Mr Speaker, that Labor had put in place a bill that actually said, you've got to stop work at 10 o'clock and you've got to stop work for 10 minutes. The bill, the Act of Parliament, did no such thing. All it did was simply provide for 2 10-minute tea breaks and a half-hour lunch break for the average length working day. It was no more prescriptive or restrictive than that. And yet, there's the National Party pretending that there was a straitjacketed Act of Parliament that was creating havoc throughout the workplaces in this land, and that is a load of rubbish. Some of the stories that led me to argue for this area of law to be fixed up were from people in very vulnerable parts of our employment area, Mr Speaker. So the particular group that came to see me were people working in service stations in the Waikato.
I'm not going to get a break now.
And they were in a position where they could not take a meal break at all during the day. Because what had happened, well, you know, the members opposite may find this extremely funny, but actually what had happened was that the staff had been cut, the staffing hours had been cut for the service stations right throughout the area. Now, we all know that gas companies have been making money hand over fist, and yet they were cutting back hours. They cut back the hours to the bone, and it meant that every time a car drove onto the forecourt, the worker that may have been trying to have their meal break had to stop eating their lunch, go out and serve that customer, which meant that repeatedly they were not getting meal breaks. And so that was the group that came to see me, and then in further investigation I discovered it was an even larger problem. But I do wonder what investigation the Minister has done before she has gone down this path, because in 2006 there was an investigation into the causative factors associated with summertime workplace fatalities. An important piece of work because, amongst other things, what it discovered was that here in New Zealand there are two peak times when work-related fatal incidents are most likely to occur. And I'd really like the Minister to take heed of this because it's very important with regard to this bill. One of those peak times is in the late morning, between 10:30 and 12:30. The other is mid-afternoon, between 2:30 and 3:30. The trend is applicable for all industries, but is particularly relevant to the agricultural sector. Now, that's the sort of thing that the Minister ought to be taking into account, because it screams out to me, Mr Speaker, that those are times of day when people ought to have had a break. And they should have actually taken that 10 minutes to actually have a drink of water, and I feel like I'm going to need to do that myself in a minute, Mr Speaker. Have a drink of water, rehydrate, get their energy levels back up again, take a little bit of break from work, and then get back into it. Because that, the evidence internationally and in New Zealand tells us that that actually prevents deaths in our workplaces. That's the reason for rest periods and meal breaks. Not so you can shuffle it to the end of your shift, just before you're about to go off and have the big break anyway, but actually to prevent accidents from happening in the workplace. Mr Speaker, I think that it's very interesting that the Minister not only has not looked at that research that was done here in New Zealand in preparing this bill, but further than that, she also didn't listen to her own officials. She also did not listen to her own officials when they warned her, and the official documents tell us that they warned her, not to have a knee-jerk response to the airline dispute that was happening at the time. They said, Minister, this is an industrial dispute. Do not have a knee-jerk legislative response to this, because if you become the kind of minister, they said to the minister, not to you, Mr Speaker, that uses legislation to intervene in industrial disputes, there will be no end to this. Did that minister listen? The minister clearly did not listen. She went to get her official's advice. She has not looked at the research and evidence. She does not care about health and safety in the workplace. She does not understand the role of meal breaks and rest periods with regard to health and safety in the workplace, and she is putting New Zealand workers at risk.
Keith